Is that true or false?
It depends what your worst fear is. My worst fear is I guess it's thinking you know someone and then waving at them and then realising it's not actually the person you thought it was. So I'd rather do that than die.
Some phobias are worse than other phobias, like homophobia. I'm not homophobic. I'm homophobic in the same sense that I'm arachnophobic. I'm not scared of spiders, I'm not scared of gays, though I would probably scream if I saw one in my bath.
Johnny, so what's your genuine biggest fear?
You don't want to know.
No, I do. I do want to know. Come on. It's not too far-fetched. Just tell us, what's your fear?
My biggest fear is, right, time travel being developed.
Right. No, shush. It's his greatest fear.
Going back in time to meet myself.
All right.
To warn myself about what I could become, but then talking myself into being a bigger twat.
My biggest fear is that me and Johnny have got to share a car back up north after the show.
Ulrika, what's your greatest fear?
Claustrophobia. When I was in Big Brother, I had to make them say that they wouldn't lock the diary room when I was in there.
What, because you got a bit claustrophobic?
A little bit panicky, yeah.
Sean, what is your greatest fear?
What's my worst fear?
Yeah, what's your biggest fear?
I have a recurring nightmare where I'm in a tug of war and I've got the rope around me and I look down and I'm wearing flip-flops. That's horrible.
Do you think 33% of people would rather die than face their worst fear?
No.
Jason?
It seems silly, doesn't it?
Yeah.
It seems silly. No, I think we don't think people would rather die than face their own fear.
So you're saying false? You're saying false, Sean?
Yes.
OK, I can tell you the answer is false. Only 9% of people would rather die than face their worst fear. Franklin D. Roosevelt famously said, "The only thing we have to fear is fear itself." Of course, he's dead now, killed by a massive spider. OK, what do you like the look of, Jason?
Let's go with this lady who's just finishing breastfeeding.
You have chosen Britain's oldest mother. This week, Britain's oldest mother, 66-year-old Elizabeth Adenay, brought her baby home from hospital. Congratulations, if you're watching. So we polled the studio audience and asked them, is 66 too old to have a baby? Yes or no?
I do think it's
too old. But you've got children.
Yeah, but I'm not 66.
Are you not? I had no idea. Sorry. I'm kidding.
No, but think about how cool your grandparents are. Your grandparents are fun because they, you know, they're a bit of a laugh, aren't they? And instantly, bang, you've got one. You know what I mean?
Also, for him, it's brilliant. Like, he's upstairs in his room and his mum shouts up, "Come on, get your breakfast ready." She can't get up there. She's got to strap herself into the chair. Press the button. Zzz, I'm coming up there. Coming to get you. Be up there in a minute.
You've borrowed that money, haven't you?
You busted. You got the other way. I'm coming back down again.
I've forgotten what I came upstairs for.
The brilliant thing for her is, at her age, and breastfeeding is, she doesn't have to pick him up to breastfeed. She just goes like that. Like that. Feed it. Like, you're finished.
I imagine he's getting powdered milk out of them.
Dust at first. Mum's gone up. Oh. And then it's like sort of potato water. You know when you peel potatoes? There's a bit of nourishment in there.
Something.
My wife's pregnant at the moment. We're expecting twins in August, right? And
yeah,
we're...
And the other great news, I don't know if people know this, but Jason's wife is 67. So it's going to be a new record.
Into the record books. But one of the things she's scared of is the pain aspect, the pain aspect of childbirth, right? But I don't think it looks that painful. And if you think about it, you know, sometimes... I mean, you're a case in point. You had one baby, painful, I understand, but after a little while, you thought, might have another one. Now, a kick in the balls, right, that's painful. And I've never met a bloke who's gone, "Do you know what, lads, I could do another kick in the balls." So, essentially, that is the worst pain you can go through.
So we polled the studio audience and asked them, is 66 too old to have a baby, yes or no? Jason, you're going for?
I think the audience probably said yes.
OK, and Sean?
I think they probably said no.
You think they said no?
I think they're a very tolerant bunch to me.
OK, I can tell you the answer is 91% of our studio audience said yes, 66 is too old to have a baby. What they think. So at the end of that round, it's 4 points for Sean's team and 4 points for Jason's team, neck and neck, as we enter the final round. And the winner is the name of our final round. Here is your first one. Most hated chore.
Sexual intercourse.
of soiled bedding when it's not your house.
Oh, hang on a second. I've just got. I'll just be with you in 1 second. Okay. Most hated chore.
Is it
emptying the bins?
Is it cleaning the oven?
But I think Vegas has got that absolutely right. That's the right answer. The most hated chore is cleaning the oven. OK. Most widely believed conspiracy theory. What do you think? Johnny?
Britain's Got Talent.
Is it the moon landings? That always comes up, doesn't it? They say that the moon landings are fake and they've... And, you know, the some of the evidence is starting, like, you know, the flag's blowing and there's, how can it be blowing? It's on, there's no wind. And the shadows, they're all in the wrong way. And on one picture, there's a clanger just waving in the background.
Is it the one about the day that Jesus married Mary Magdalene, moved to France and had three children, which is obviously nonsense because Jesus hated the French. He used to say, love one another, not the French. Is it the one about the police? They drive around London at night, pulling all the tramps into a van, then they take them to an underground warehouse and they have to work on treadmills to power the London Eye. Is it that one, Jimmy? Or is it the one about the fact... Is it the one about the fact that all human life died out 10,000 years ago and we're all robots and we all know it, but we don't like people mentioning it?
Why would you say that?
Yeah, so you don't like it, do you?
OK, the most widely held conspiracy that involves the American government...
Is it Area 51?
That is exactly right, Jack Whitehall.
Good man.
Yes, the most widely believed conspiracy theory is Area 51 exists to investigate aliens. The thing is, if aliens don't exist, then who was it that abducted me at the age of 13, transported me to a room with strange flashing lights, and subjected me to a terrifying rectal probing? Oh, that's right, it was the guy that ran the youth centre disco. Well, that sound tells me it's the end of the round and the end of the show, which means the final scores are Sean, Johnny and Alex have 5, Jason, Ulrika and Jack have 5 points. It's a dead heat. Thanks to all our panellists, our wonderful studio audience and all of you for watching at home. That's it from us. Good night.